bit drowsy.
Come on, get up.
Oh, Nibbles, you's a naughty kitty, aren't you?
All right, I'm up.
Know much about this isle. Stronger than me, I'm so sorry.
Wake up.
Right, just a wee. Stronger than me, I'm so sorry.
Wake up.
I'm awake. Wide awake.
Come on, keep moving.
If you're a wee bit drowsy.
Trying to flee the food. Stubby legs, too slow. Show me what you got. Missing dwarves. Shame he's dead.
Gone.
Wake up.
I don't want to go to school. Drowsy.
Come on, get up.
Oh, Nibbles, you's a naughty.
feel a wee bit drowsy. Oh.
Wake up.
I'm awake. Wide awake.
Come on, keep moving.
So, what is it brought you to this strange place?
Looking for someone.
Here?
Mm-hmm. Just kind of turned out that way.
Not too keen on talking about it, are you?
Not really. Brought you your friend.
Ah, sure. Let's hear him then.
Wake up.
I'm awake.
Just stand! Stand back! I'm opening the door!
Gaspard! You seem a bit muddled.
Muddled. A bit drowsy, that's all.
What of the others?
Found one near a monster's den. He was already dead, sadly. Saw another fall from a cliff. Broke his neck.
Shit. Roderick told me to have an eye on the snot. 'Twas his nephew. Thanks for helping, and sorry I didn't trust you.
Oh, everything's gone wrong. What'll we do now?
Got a boat. You can leave with me, but I need to find someone first.
An ashen-haired lass?
Yes.
Oh, dreadful sorry.
What do you mean?
She's cold. Spirits left her.
Must have passed shortly before we found her.
Let's wait by the boat.
Guess not all of Vesemir's teachings have receded into oblivion.
A Witcher can forget to eat, to drink, to breathe even. But a Witcher never, ever forgets to care for his blade.
I used to repeat that incessantly. Never tired of doing it either.
What creature was it?
Huh? Creature?
One that gave you the scar over your left eye. It's new. I don't remember it.
Souvenir from the Cockatrice of Spala. Another addition to the collection. Nothing special. Yours has healed beautifully, though.
Avalok. He prepared some special ointments for me. But that was before the curse gripped him. Wonder where he is now.
We lifted the curse. He's at Kaer Morhen, waiting for you.
Are you serious? You must be. You'd not jest about something like that. A nice thing to wake up to.
You trust him?
Avalok? He's not let me down to date. Not once.
Why exactly is Avalok helping you? Sages have never been fond of humans.
He doesn't do it for me. It's about my power. As if it could ever be about anything else. Avalok tried to teach me how to control my ability. He was also making sure I didn't fall into Eridan's hands.
What's Eridan after? What's he want from you?
What everyone wants. Control of my powers. His homeworld faces annihilation. Eridan's decided to invade ours. Brilliant, wouldn't you say? Can't achieve much on his own, so he needs to bring an army. Except his navigators can't possibly move him and thousands of NL between planes. Their abilities won't allow it.
Whereas yours will.
Exactly. And if I die in the process, well, that's a necessary sacrifice.
How do you ever start traveling with Avalok?
As soon as I'd left you and Yen on the Isle of Avalon, I found myself pursued. Eridan and his Red Riders were on my heels. I fled through many worlds, many times. They came very close to catching me once. It was then that Avalok appeared, out of nowhere. He found a portal, and took us to a world where Eridan couldn't find us for, oh, perhaps half a year.
The world where Eridan couldn't find you, what was it like?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
People there had metal in their heads, waged war from a distance, using things similar to megascopes. And there were no horses. Everyone had their own flying ship instead.
Ciri, stop fooling around.
Told you you wouldn't believe me. We should have stayed there.
So why'd you return?
I thought the Hunt had lost my scent for good. I thought I was safe. Besides, I wanted to find you. You and Yennefer.
You were looking for us. We were looking for you. Times I thought you were just a step away. Other times, felt like I was going around in circles.
I'm not surprised. There were times I fled pell-mell headfirst and forward.
How'd you wind up here? What happened?
Last I remember, I was on the Skellige shore, arguing with Avalok. He wanted to take me somewhere safe. After that, nothing but dreams.
What did you dream? I've had nothing but nightmares lately. Pretty horrible.
Likewise, for the most part. In one, a monster grown from a stillborn child chased you. Ugh, that was horrible. Had a few nice dreams. For example, in one we sat around a fire, drinking good wine, and all around people danced and laughed.
I like that one a lot better.
Me too. But these dreams, and the others, ended in some tower. No matter what I'd dream, in the end, I would enter a tower.
Recognize it? Know where it might be?
Not sure. I don't think so, but there was something familiar about it. And something terrifying. The tower was stark and dead. But at the same time, I felt I had to enter it.
Did you?
No. Dreams all ended with me searching for the entrance. And the last time, instead of the tower, I saw your grizzled face. If not for the scar over your eye, I'd have thought I was still dreaming.
I was afraid you were dead. Found some dwarves here. Said they'd try to wake you, but you were cold as ice, and you weren't breathing.
And yet you came in.
Who listens to dwarves these days? Speaking of which, they're probably getting antsy. We should go. Got a boat on the beach. Once we land, we'll head for Kaer Morhen, on horseback.
Right. Conventional means of travel. They're just better.
Though a portal would be quicker.
And draw Eredin to us immediately. Rather not risk it. Besides, I hate portals. Damn. Listen, we gotta think of a way to...
Welcome back, child.
Siri! My, you've grown beautiful.
No point standing around. Come on, time to greet the others.
You've not changed a bit. Any of you. All just like I remembered.
What?
Little sis.
Here, everyone you asked for help. Avalox resting in the tower, still in pretty bad shape. No reason to do it out here. Come inside.
Damn, it's good to see you again.
Maybe I'll give you two a moment.
Triss, please.
No, you must have missed each other terribly. A minute's delay won't hurt anyone.
No, we should get going. They're waiting for us.
Yen, you know the Wild Hunt better than anyone else. Tell us about the magic they use.
They're never... Good to see you. We might counter the Dimeridian or our own magic. They also...
Ha! Your phone now.
They told me the hunt was after her, that those buggers might burst in uninvited. So I've made a Mahakaman mix. When this power is low, yes, so they work.
She's one of us, Geralt. No way we'll let him take her. Damn.
Esco.
Greetings, Wolf.
Get everybody together. Time to talk. Thank you for coming. The Wild Hunt will be here soon. They're coming for Ciri. Want to take her? We'll stop them.
How do you even know the Hunt will show?
They always know where I teleport to, and they move from place to place in an instant.
So what's our plan?
There aren't many of us, but I'd trust any of you with my life. Work together and we'll defeat the Hunt. When they attack, Yen will dome the fortress with a magic shield. Hunt will be forced to land outside the walls.
If they're dispersed out in the woods, we could hunt down small groups of riders.
Got our first volunteer for the hunting party. I'm the second.
The Hunt will try to penetrate into the fortress through navigator portals. I can do nothing against this kind of magic, so you'll need to find and close as many as you can while hunting in the woods.
Lambert will make us dimeridium bombs. Remember the formula?
Of course.
Excellent. Erdin should work on the portals as well. I shall also give you each an amulet. Snap them in half and you'll become invisible, at least while you remain still or move slowly. Move abruptly, engage any foes, clash with them, and they will see you. Apart from that, they will be able to hear you and smell you. If you come across a large unit, do not attack. Signal Triss and she will provide support.
I'll look for your signal. Soon as I see it, I'll rain fire on the forest.
Ciri's most important in all of this. The Hunt's after her, and we have to defend her at all costs.
What do I do?
Stay inside the keep. If they break through, come inside. We'll all converge to help you.
Out of the question! I can look after myself.
No one doubts that, child. But remember the most important moment when hunting a monster?
Wait for an opportunity. After the council, I'll give you an amulet. If you use it, a ball of fire will land where you're standing, just in case.
What else do we have that we can use?
I brought this Mahakaman mix. Flammable as bone-dry saltpeter and plowing sticks to everything. We fill some barrels, stack them in a narrow passage, and fire them up at an opportune moment.
You know, we stand on a vast deposit of gas. If need be, I could open cracks in the earth, create explosions. I would need to prepare, though.
There's a laboratory and the workshop.
One thing to remember, we've got limited resources and even less time. We ought to decide what kind of weaponry will be most useful against the Hunt.
Absolutely. We need to assign one type of weaponry each to the lab and workshop.
Who needs access to the lab?
I started brewing some potions. Like to finish, if you don't mind.
I could prepare more of those Witcher's traps, but I'd need all the lab equipment.
There aren't many of us, so we'll need to prepare as many traps as possible.
Let's talk about the workshop. Been wanting to fix that breach in the wall, but we'll need the same tools to clear the rubble from the armory.
Rubble?
Haven't you heard? Roof caved in a couple of years back. There's some excellent swords in there. Swords we could use.
Filling in the breach seems just as important. They come through there, the siege will be over awfully quick.
We'll need weapons that can pierce the Hunt's armor. Gotta clear the armory.
We won't have time to do much else. Everything settled?
Yes, settled. We don't have much time, so let's get to work.
Let's sum up. Yennefer will create a magic barrier to repel the main assault. That should push the opposing force into the woods, where Lambert and Geralt will be waiting. They'll use Dimeridium to close the Navigator's portals, stop as many warriors as possible from entering the fortress. Triss will be waiting for their signal, then give the Riders hell. All others will repel any foes who make it inside the fortress walls.
If anything goes wrong, we abandon the outer courtyard, pull back to the keep. Remember, Eridan can't get his hands on Ciri. That's most important. Let's look at the map of the fortress, figure out the details. Can't help feeling we've overlooked something important.
Don't think about it.
Wanted to talk about what we can expect.
Thanks, not interested. You should talk to Ciri, fine mood she's in.
I'm exposing you all to danger, unnecessarily.
You worry too much. Wipe that frown off your face, we'll make it.
Can't help but worry. We're short on meteorite steel swords.
Got enough for everyone. Here, Vesemir dug this up for you. Gnome forged blade, Crossguard's elven handiwork. Cuts through armor like butter.
Thanks for everything.
I'll saddle the horses. Come once you're ready to head into the woods.
it's starting. The woods, now.
Gonna have to thank Yen once this is all over. That spell, really something.
And the invisibility.
Hounds could sniff you out, so don't get too close. And you'll be visible as soon as you start fighting. Remember that. Good work with these bombs, by the way.
Aim at the portals. Be precise. I'm out of dimeridium.
Yen mentioned casting the Erden at the rifts. Said the sign could seal them.
They're here. Time to say hello.
Slow down. Element of surprise is key. Stay hidden. Give Triss a chance to show them what she can do. Then we'll hit him.
Next time you get the feeling I'm about to piss off Marigold, make sure and knock me upside the head.